So the question that happened to come up was, I teach in a classroom of 100 students. I teach in a classroom of 80 students. It is it is just so difficult very often to do that. I think there are a couple of things, right? So firstly, there is no reason that you need to make it very, very high stakes. I always thought that when you make something very high stakes, it just becomes, you blame yourself very easily when you fail. So always a good chance to start experimenting with it, with differentiation, but also it's a great opportunity to leverage students in your classroom. Maybe a large chunk of your students your students are very unique. We've discussed this, right? All students are unique. Every child is unique, right? And therefore, you can leverage students who have interests and they're good at their interests to support other students. You can leverage students who are highly ready to support other students. And then your support can be targeted to specific groups for that lesson, right? So again, don't think of it as in every lesson, my class of 100 students, I have to support all 100 students. Over the duration of a week, can I provide support to all groups? While other groups work independently on meaningful tasks that help them learn. I also just read Sabyasachi's comment on multi-ability classrooms, and I genuinely couldn't have put that better. It's a pleasure to teach in that classroom because it really brings the spirit of teaching alive, and I've always enjoyed that. It's just a wonderful, wonderful experience. And yes, it makes flipped classrooms a reality. And in addition, differentiation is also really fun to do once we get the hang of it and once you feel comfortable. It's really fun to do.